Welcome to Stern FX. My name is Eran Stern, and this time I want to share a simple trick to create a seamless texture for reflection that works best for environment layers inside After Effects. So I already started working on this composition. I'll press spacebar to preview it, and we can see that we have a clouds video in the background, and on top of it, two 3D layers, the AE text as well as a shape layer. Now, both of those are extruded thanks to the fact that I'm using the Cinema 4D renderer. And I also have a point light that casts some shadows over here. All right, now to make it look a bit more believable, what I would like to do is reflect the background on these 3D elements. And you can do it quite easily inside After Effects by selecting the background layer and then pressing Command or Control D to duplicate it, and then right-click on it and select Environment Layer. This is going to switch off the visibility of this layer. It will only show up in the reflection. And to set it up, I need to select those two 3D layers and then open its settings and drill down the material options and change their reflection intensity. I'll take it all the way to 100%. Since both of the layers are selected, it's going to affect both of them. Now, the problem, because we are not using a 360 HDRI image, is that we are going to see an obvious seam. And to show it to you, I'll press the letter C, which is going to switch me to the Orbit tool. I'll click and start to orbit, and here it is. This is the obvious seam because it is using a regular plane layer. This is obviously not a seamless reflection. So to remedy this, I'll select the reflection layer, I'll go to the layer menu, and I'll pre-compose it. I'll name this one Reflection. I'll make sure to leave all attributes in this composition and open it. I'll click Open, and here we are inside this composition. Now I'll select the layer, go to the Effect menu, and under the Distort category, I'll add the Offset effect. I'll change the Shift Center to 0 and 0 for both the X and the Y. And this is going to show us the problem in its full glory. So you can see those edges are not merging together. This is why we saw the obvious seam. So I'll return to the Effect menu. This time, I'll go to the Keying category and I'll take the CC Simple Wire Removal effect. I'll change the thickness to 50. As well as 50% for the mirror blend. And then I'll take those two points A and B and place them above and beyond the comp. I'll duplicate the effect by pressing Command D. And then I'll take those two points again. This time I'll move it to the edges of the comp, so left and right. And these two effects will help to blend the edges very nicely together. So if I'll return back to the original composition, we can see that the seam is gone and we have a seamless reflection. I'll press C again and just orbit around the scene to show you that no matter what I'm doing with those 3D objects, we are not going to see any obvious problems with the texture. Of course, this is a poor man's solution, but I can tell you that this is going to work beautiful for most cases. And to prove it, I'll go to the beginning of this composition, then click on the Active Camera pop-up menu and select Create Camera from 3D View. Then go to the Animation menu, ask After Effects to reveal all modified properties. And now I can keyframe the point of interest as well as the position. Go to the end of this composition and orbit the camera to a different angle, something along those lines. And go to the beginning, maximize the composition panel, and preview this composition. And as you can see, the result is very convincing. So, this is it for this one. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this information was useful. Please like and subscribe, and I will see you again in the next one.